been suggested to start a medication called spironolactone for your acne. Now, the interesting thing is that spironolactone is not FDA approved to treat acne. It's actually a blood pressure medication. Now, spironolactone works by blocking the effects of testosterone, the male predominant hormone, in your skin. Now, if we think about it, testosterone is what gives us oil. Oil is what feeds the whole cycle of acne. So if we're blocking the effects of testosterone on the skin, then hopefully we're reducing the excessive oil that's produced in the skin, and then that's how your acne gets better. Now, it's not too often prescribed for blood pressure because it really doesn't do that much for blood pressure unless you increase the doses very high. But what they noticed when they did the studies decades ago on this was that women who took spironolactone and had acne, almost all of their acne went away. And so dermatologists, we've been writing spironolactone for decades, and we've had very good luck with it. It's almost like a miracle medication for women who have acne, especially acne in areas where men have a beard and when you get it on your forehead. And if you have that type of acne and it flares right around your menstrual cycle, then spironolactone is probably going to be the home run for your acne. Now, it's a very safe medication, but like all medications, it does have some precautions. One, you shouldn't be pregnant or breastfeeding. And if you have any questions about your pregnancy status, you should do a pregnancy test before you take this medication. If you take this medication while pregnant, and you keep taking it past, 6 or 7 weeks of gestation of when you conceived, and the fetus growing inside of you is male, there is a possibility that this medication could feminize the male fetus growing inside of you. We don't want that. Now, you also need to have a healthy heart and healthy kidneys. So you can't be a transplant patient or have heart conditions or have kidney conditions. And if you do, this medication is not right for you. This medication can adjust the levels of potassium in your blood. So we ask you to keep a steady diet and not have potassium-rich foods, a bunch of them one day and none the next. You need to kind of keep your potassium-rich foods to a reasonable amount. The doses that we prescribe in dermatology are usually less than 100 milligrams a day. We usually prescribe those in the morning because this blood pressure medication will make you pee a little bit more for an hour or two after you take it. So if you take it right before you go to bed at night, you might be a little frustrated at us because you'll be getting up in an hour to use the bathroom. We usually recommend taking this medication with food so that it doesn't upset your belly. Now, in the doses that we give in dermatology, usually it is about 1% of people who have any sort of side effects. Sometimes some dizziness with standing. Sometimes some menstrual irregularities. Sometimes a little bit of belly pain. Sometimes some breast tenderness. But it's usually less than 1% of the population. If you have any of these side effects, though, please stop the medication. Talk to your local healthcare provider. The first thing we usually do if you have any of these side effects is just decrease how much of the medication you get all at once. So for instance, if you were taking 50 milligrams in the morning and it was upsetting your belly, or you had a little bit of dizziness with standing, usually we would do 25 milligrams with breakfast and 25 milligrams with lunch, and it usually takes care of the side effects. There are three main problems with this medication. Number one, just like all acne treatments, it takes about 6 weeks before you'll start noticing the medication's working. So please be patient. Problem number two, and we've already discussed this, pregnancy or breastfeeding does not mix with this medication. Problem number three, there is a warning on this medication that it could increase the risk of breast cancer development. Now, if you look at the data, it's actually going to show it decreases the risk of breast cancer. And the breast cancer that it decreases the risk of are the low-grade forms of breast cancer. It doesn't do much for the really bad high-grade forms of breast cancer, but it does seem to be reducing the risk of the low-grade. Regardless of that, if you have a family history of breast cancer, I do recommend having a discussion with your local healthcare provider to make sure this medication's right for you. Sometimes your local healthcare provider is going to want to do a blood test on you while taking spironolactone, just to make sure your electrolytes and other values in your body are doing okay. We usually do not do those lab draws unless you're having unusual side effects or symptoms, or if we're increasing the dose above 100 milligrams or 150 milligrams a day. Please have a conversation with your local healthcare provider to see if and when they want to do lab draws while you're on this medication. And I would recommend for all of these medications that you read the package insert before you take the medication. You need to know what the risks and side effects are for these medications. And the best way for you to do that is to read the package insert and then to ask your local healthcare provider if there's any questions that you have before you start taking the medication. Now, listen, a lot of people don't want to take a blood pressure medication for their acne. And I understand that. But please also understand that when this medication is prescribed and it's followed religiously and you have a communication with your local healthcare provider about any side effects or symptoms that you're having, it is amazing. It is often what we call the miracle drug. Sometimes people have been on 2, 3, 4 rounds of Accutane, and it gets better while they're on Accutane, but it just always comes back 6 months later. We give them this blood pressure medication, and 6 weeks later they come back in tears, hugging, crying. It's just an amazing treatment. So please don't let it scare you.